The Rebbe took this project as his own personal project. I know for the fact that Rabbi Hecht was writing to him, if not every day, every other day, or every two, 3 days, to mention to him about all the plan, future plan, and what happened and all these things. And he always was in contact with him. And anytime we had any questions or there was anything, either within an hour or within a half a day, we would get an answer, and he would give us the answer for it. And one of the things that he did was from his personal money, he made baskets of shalachmanots to give to every kid. And this was done in his house on President Street, and it was given to every kid from President Street to every kid. And it was very, very beautiful basket with all types of chocolates and all types of nash and cookies. Very, very fancy looking too. Huge ones. Some of them was even hard for the little kids to carry it. And he gave to every kid one of them. He also, by Pesach night, came to visit the Seder in Hadarat Torah, 824 Eastern Parkway. We made a huge Pesach night, and he personally came, and he spoke for about 3, 4, 5 minutes to welcome all the kids, and he went also to Machon Chana that night. He walked all the way to Machon Chana to go greet all the girls also. One of the amazing things happened was one of the boys who was around, I would say, 10, 12 years old, he always davened mincha by him and ma'ariv by the Rebbe. And in the small shul, and he used to go and stand all the way in the front. And he used to miss his dinner. So when he came to have a dinner in 824, we already served dinner, and there was no kind of a dinner for him. So we used to try to give him a few dollars to go have a dinner or whatever. So after a while, he didn't go. So the Rebbe asked Rabbi J.J. Hecht, where is the kid? And Rabbi Hecht got in touch with Shapsi Chaitin and I, and he said, where the kid? So we find the kid. The kid left to L.A. So the Rebbe asked that we should go to L.A. and find how he is, which it wasn't a nice, I don't want to say a nice thing, but we came to L.A., both of us, and we look for him. We look all over for him, and we found him. Unfortunately, he was touch out of derech. That's why the Rebbe told us, I want you to go to L.A. and find him. So we went to him and we talked to him. He had he grew a very long hair, and I told him that the Rebbe misses you, and the fact that you miss your food and your dinner, and you stayed there, you daven ma'ariv with him, stays with the Rebbe, and he loves you very much, and wherever you are, it's fine. I'm not asking you to come back. I want you to know that Rebbe loves you, and he wants you to stay for who you are and what you learned, and he promised me. He said, don't look at my face, that I have things on my face. Don't look at my hair. I'm not really that. I'm a good kid. I said, you have a beautiful neshama, and I trust you. And just try to stay straight, and try to stay as your ancestors. And he promised. So I didn't hear from him for about 25 years. And a few years ago, I heard that he's one of the big supporters of the Chabad, and he goes to shul every Shabbos and puts on tefillin every day. I was very, very happy.